You are now plugged into The Review, giving you our 2 cents and dollars too.
Yeah.
What's going on, y'all? Welcome back to another review. And as Telly likes to say,
what's popping? What's happening? What's going on? Or whatever.
Yes. So we're back to discuss Insecure.
And listen,
Insecure. Episode 7.
We'll have one more?
Yeah, I think we got one more.
One more episode. God, dog, what in the world are they going to get in one episode?
Baby, all I know is I better see a couple of people before
they come out. Oh, and we said what we're going to start doing is introducing ourselves as well.
Mm-hmm.
Because everybody who watches do not know who we are.
Right.
Okay, so I'm Kajoy, and that is my real name. Okay, Mika is short for Tamika. All right, Joy is actually my middle name, J-O-I.
Oh, look at that.
It is. Because, you know, sometimes people be out here just making up names. You know, if you think about somebody like Jamie Foxx.
Oh, yeah, that's nice.
Is that Madonna's real name?
You know, I don't know.
You know, people make up names. But no, Mika Joy is actually. I'm sorry.
And I am Telly Mo, and that is actually a part of my name. My first name is Shantelly, and my last name I'm not going to tell y'all.
I almost said my last name too. I had to stop myself.
I'm not going to tell y'all.
If you know me, then you know what it is. If you
Hello.
Don't, it's not me. If you
there
know
you
right
have
now.
It. But yes, I am Telly Mo. How y'all doing?
So, did y'all make our little intro?
Listen, we worked hard.
Mm.
You should have seen how many outtakes we have.
Okay. For real. But, you know, we have been saying, I think since our second video, because our first video was in Starbucks, right? Mm-hmm. So we really didn't plan on, this thing like
really being a thing.
Being an ongoing thing. But, mm-hmm. you know, we really liked it. We got some good feedback. And we was like, we're going to do this.
Yep.
So, because we made the decision to do this, we felt like we needed a little name.
Yep, we got
so,
it.
Yeah, the review actually came from a mutual Facebook friend of ours.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, shout out to Tony. I don't know if he would ever watch this, but we got to show you some love, okay? Because
you did.
This was your baby.
Mm-hmm. We appreciate it.
But it was so, it's so fitting. It's like, it's exactly what we are. We are reviewing, okay? Not only TV shows, what we're going to talk about. Books.
And movies.
And, yeah. So the review was, like, real proper. Like, it was appropriate for what we're doing here. So. Did I scare you?
No.
Also, I'm excited, y'all, because as a creative, right, me and Telly been sitting here talking, rapping, and it's like, I just got so excited.
Mm-hmm.
If you're a creative and you're watching, you know what it's like to when you get an idea and it's like so clear and it's like so...
And it's coming to life.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
It's a beautiful feeling. It really, it is. So I'm trying to kind of bring it down a notch. But anyway, so we decided, well, Telly, it was actually Telly's idea. Tell them what the idea was.
What, the paper? Oh,
listen, I'll let her tell her idea.
So we're going to have our own YouTube channel.
Yeah,
we're going to have our own YouTube channel. So be on the lookout for that. We're going to be having a lot of things.
And probably by the time this video go up, though, we'll go ahead and set it up. So if we do, which that's my plan, once I edit and all that, maybe I'll throw it in somewhere down here, maybe in the description box. For those of you who read the description box, and maybe if I tell you something gonna be there, you'll actually go and read.
Right.
You know? So yeah, we are going to have our own YouTube, okay? Because we've been posting videos here on my channel. But yeah, when Telly brought that to my attention, I was like, we should do that. That's a good idea.
So that's what we're gonna do.
Mm-hmm.
Have our own.
It's beautiful how ideas just
start rolling, moving.
But anyway, let's get into Insecure, shall
we? Let's do it,
Come on now. So where we starting at? I think we should start from the beginning. Because you like to skip. You like to
But no, this time the beginning is necessary.
Okay.
This time the beginning is necessary.
Paint the picture.
This episode really touched me because, one, I know every woman has felt the way Issa has felt.
Yes, Lord.
In this episode.
Yes, Lord.
So, we still don't know where Nathan is in the beginning. She's been waiting for his
call. What do you mean in the beginning? In the end? The middle and the end? We still don't know where homeboy at.
She only saying all that because she don't like him. Okay?
That's facts though. We still do not know where he is. No one has heard from Nathan.
We don't know where he is, but opening of the show, she sleeps. She keeps having falling out. Which I wanted to Google to see what that meant.
Might have a meaning.
I think it means like someone's dying, dead, or something.
Really?
Like that. Yeah, I gotta Google it. But she keeps checking her phone. So she wakes up, starts talking to herself in the head, like, "Hey, what time is it? Did he text me yet?" I'm talking about every time that phone vibrate, she think it's him. And it's not him.
That thing is something real, honey.
Even in the shower, she was like, "Ooh, he texted me while I'm in the shower. Ooh, he nasty." And it was her mama texting her Bible scriptures.
That poor baby.
And then her phone fell in the shower. She was like, yeah. "No."
You know, but it's so real. And mm-hmm. I think that's what a lot of us like about Insecure is that this is like real life stuff.
It's relatable.
Relatable. There you go. Mm-hmm. Because I've been that chick, and I'm talking about more than once.
Hello.
And it's like you sit back and you like, I mean, that's real for me talking to this popcorn in my mouth, but you sit back and you wonder like, okay, well,
what is Buddy doing?
She was vibing, everything was cool, the chemistry was right. I feel like I just spit out a kernel. The chemistry was right. You know what I'm saying? Like, what happened?
We was just laying in the bed together a week ago.
He asked her. Since that's your boy, I'm pretty sure you know word for word what he said to her.
He asked her, "How do you know if this is real?" He was all in a daze. I think he just got caught up in his feelings.
Where is my Johnny? Where is my Johnny?
Number of reasons why he isn't talking to her. It could be because he in jail. A lot of people are predicting that he's in jail.
Yeah. I've asked some people on my social media and on my Instagram
saying that he might be in jail.
Yeah. I don't know. I don't know what to make of this.
I don't know, but you know, ladies, we have been Issa to where their group has a fake Instagram account. Okay.
I thought that was hilarious, girl. I've never made a fake account. Never. I've never thought about it.
Fake Instagram, Facebook. You get a distant friend that don't even, "Hey, I need you to follow him and what's your account information so I can check in every once in a while." What? Yes, ma'am.
It's done, honey. It's
finished.
Done.
Finito. But yeah. We as women can definitely relate to Issa and what she was feeling every second of the day. She was thinking about what Nathan was doing, where he was at, if he was going to text every time a phone vibrated. She was thinking that, okay, that got to be
stalking and all, honey.
Listen, when my dog saw that, oh, he cut hair? Mm-hmm. A day ago, thanks for the cut. Oh, he cut hair. He out here living his best life. Baby went to go put them shoes on.
Listen. That thing real, though. I mean, and now with social media being as big as it is, it's like everybody has an Instagram. Yeah, somebody might not have a Facebook, but everybody got an Instagram.
Oh, his friend got an Instagram.
What friend?
His friend, whoever. I'm just saying. Oh.
So, yeah, man, I've been that chick, too. I'm not even going to sit up here and act like I don't know where Issa is at currently, you know? Because I've been that. I have stalked the hell out of somebody's Instagram low-key and then sat back and been like, "Mika, why?"
Facebook. If he like anything, if he tagged in anything, if he commented anything.
Going back, looking at your favorite photos, the ones that you
listen,
didn't.
You just text him and he just commented on something 30 minutes ago and you text him an hour ago.
And you go back to double check to make sure that
it went through, that it say delivered at the end.
Or make sure that, let me double check the time because maybe this was...
Fact of the matter is, if you got time to get on social media,
you got time to respond.
Hello.
Yeah, it's not a good feeling.
It's not.
So, mm-hmm. I mean, I'm sure ladies out there watching, y'all understand. And you feel us. And you feel Issa. I feel sorry for her.
I felt bad, but listen, she took matters into her own hands when she got them keys and called her best friend. What you doing? I need you. Let me tell you something. My best friend, Benz, I call her my ride or die. Baby, anytime I used to call her and be like, hey, I need you to ride me right quick. She used to be like, okay, so do I need my sneakers? Like, do I need my Vaseline?
What I need, girl?
We just riding by or we getting out? What we doing? No questions. Like, when she ain't saying who we gonna go see, nothing. I just need you to get in the car. And she was on her way, period.
I was more of like a solo rider. Riding, I mean, because I'm kind of like a solo person anyway. If I would have called somebody and said, I need you to come ride me, like, they would have tried to talk me out of it.
Mm-hmm. She ain't talking me out of nothing.
Now, I did do a drive-by once. My sister was a driver. But, you know, we have the moment. So that is real. I mean, we could probably go on another 20 minutes about how real that thing is. I mean, it's not a good feeling either after you have decided to be intimate with this person.
Mm-hmm.
All right?
So now he's ghosted her. Now we cut to Molly and Issa in the car. They got desserts as a decoy because Molly is apologizing or trying to make amends with Andrew. Now let's cut to this date she had with Andrew.
I'm so disappointed in Molly.
Everything was going good. They was laughing. They was kicking until she got in her feelings when he mentioned Drew. Now, she was wrong for leaving that man at the bar because you was in your feelings. You remember telling him stuff. But because you butt hurt because Drew got a baby on the way.
Yeah.
You want to get mad at him because he making a joke?
She didn't have to rock it like that, though. She really didn't. And you know... It's not his fault, number one, that you're even in the situation you are. And this man is trying to get to know you. You trying to move on, supposedly. So, in that moment, I mean, if it was me, in that moment, I can say because I've done some growing.
Come on, growing?
Yes, I've just a little bit of growth. I probably would have excused myself and went to the bathroom and just tried to
I would have moosed out a little bit.
Yeah, step outside, get some fresh air or something, you know.
Mm-hmm.
But she left the man. And I texted Telly as I was watching. Andrew, you know,
he got a little flavor.
I think it's his vibe, his energy, I think is really attractive. I mean, not to mention, he's not an ugly man either.
He would have to really convince me, honey. I'm talking about convince.
Yeah, I know Telly told y'all last week that she not really into the whole... Mm-mm. I'm going to tell you, and he reminds me of the dude I was engaged to.
For real?
Yes. Not the whole ponytail thing. The ponytail, you
Come
know.
Come on, man.
But I mean, man, his...
It's just his swag and everything, what he had going on. So now, since Issa need her as a decoy, she got to talk through. Oh, sorry, y'all. I don't know what that was. But Issa got to talk to him. Molly got to talk to him. She don't want to talk to him. She's talking about something. I'm just here.
Her energy lied for her. You know what I'm saying? For real. He's sitting there looking like.
He's like, what you want? Basically, because he was at that point, I think he was just done.
He was disgusted with her
because she tried to beat him mad.
Yeah,
she tried to beat him mad about a situation she created.
I want Monty to start taking ownership
of how she feels and what she does.
Yes, I really want her as a grown woman, seriously. Because, you know, you cannot keep blaming and pointing the finger at other people. Mm-mm. I want her. I don't know if she's going to be able to do that because we only got one episode in this season. But, you know, sometime in the near future, I want her to start taking some ownership because she be wilding out, man.
Yeah, she do. She doesn't know how to control her emotions. They get mad when things don't go her way.
Is she still in the therapy?
Well, you know what? I ain't seen her go to therapy.
Not this season.
Mm-mm. I ain't seen her go to therapy yet.
She might need to make an apartment.
Listen. And he wasn't about to let them in the house neither. He had to say she had to pee. And in that pen, she had to go to his room and check out. I'm talking about, okay, is this bed made like, did he sleep in his bed last night? Or is this like a week's worth of not sleeping in the bed? Mm-hmm. Did this draw just happen to pull out like that? Or did he do that this morning? Mm-hmm. Then that laptop was there. Baby, she was about to put her name in as a password. Molly's like, what are you doing? Let's go.
And I'm talking about Inspector Gadget. She wasn't playing no names in
there. Let me tell you something. That's how it be.
Men. Have you ever gone that far, though?
Men. Okay. If you don't want your woman going through your stuff, y'all better be careful what y'all tell these women. Y'all think we forget? We don't forget nothing.
And sometimes you gotta be careful of who you dealing with, cause sometimes men see the red flag, see we a little
cuckoo for
crazy and deranged.
Let me tell you something. I have immaculate memory when it comes to certain things. I may forget where my keys is, but I ain't gonna forget where you live.
Come on, not at all.
Okay.
Not at all.
I'm not going to forget where you live. I'm not going to forget that passcode to your phone. I have a thing for numbers and patterns. Mm. Okay?
Be careful around telling that.
I'm just saying.
Be careful.
Don't tell me that your ex-girlfriend used to drive a white Altima. And then I see a white Altima in your driveway. Because I knocked on those around this thing. Okay? Hello? So, yeah.
Be careful. Yeah, men do need to be careful. And you know what? I really hope that even though I don't dig Nathan, but for Issa's sake, I would hope that wherever he is like out of his control.
Right. He better have a good excuse.
Yeah. Somebody, I would hope that he's
something wrong with your mama.
Right, right.
You
right.
In jail.
Right.
Something to where you could not contact
even
me.
Even if you
had
kids out there, you know, somebody in the hospital, you know, something like really serious that he can come back and say, this is what happened. I'm sorry I couldn't reach out to you. And then she can be like, I forgive you. I understand. Hopefully.
I really hope with that because Andrew looked like he was a little hesitant and wanted to let them in the house in the first place. So. Mm-mm.
She just, and they're just, you know, disrespecting the man altogether. You disrespected Nathan and
Andrew.
But you know what?
You don't care when you're trying to get some answers, baby. I don't care if I got to flip this whole room around and let me find a piece of paper that say that you was somewhere yesterday. A receipt.
Right, a receipt. You said you were at the Taco Bell
yesterday. Okay. And I need to know where that Taco Bell at because maybe that Taco Bell needs to
what order.
Maybe you be around at Taco Bell across the street. That's where you cut hair at. I don't know. But guess what? I'm going to ride about it.
Yeah. So what else happened? I will say we did not see Daniel.
Again, we didn't see him again.
Along with Nathan, but I didn't miss Nathan at all. But Daniel.
You know what I'm doing, my friend?
I did miss Daniel. Where he at?
I don't know. Maybe he'll be in this last episode.
I hope so.
Maybe he'll be in this last episode. But we did see Lawrence, and he went to church.
Good. Yes, honey, he was looking good, honey. With them slacks like a turquoise, or
but he
was
did
looking
look good,
honey. He was looking good in them now. He went up in that church house.
He went to church, and he was really trying to find something, find himself, get back to himself. And what was funny was his best friend went up to the altar. He didn't even go. His best friend went to the altar and and got prayer talking about something. He was so lost. I've been feeling so lost.
He a mess.
But you see how old girl checked for him after church, though. She was pretty, too.
But do you think, as a woman, do you think it's okay to approach? Like, I like her approach. It wasn't strong, it wasn't aggressive.
She just the whole conversation.
It was, yeah. Yeah. As a woman, I've approached.
Oh, I definitely have.
Yeah. You know, it took me a long time because, you know, I kind of felt like, should I? Or how do I? Like, how do you? You know what I'm saying? But as I've gotten older, I'm in a place. Now, I know not every woman feels this way, but I'm in a place where it's okay not to be aggressive, but...
If I'm interested, I'm going for it. Okay, so
aggressively, you don't care.
Yeah, it all depends on where I'm at and what we're doing.
Okay.
The setting, if it's
the atmosphere.
If I have to be aggressive and let you know what my intentions are, I'm going to let you know. Because say for instance, we are in a room full of people. It's women everywhere. Mm-hmm. Women trying to get your attention. Mm-hmm. I'm going to get your attention.
Okay.
I will be the one.
Okay.
To get your attention.
So you are aggressive.
I will get those teachers if I really want.
Okay. Yes, ma'am.
All right.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Yeah. I'm just gonna put these up.
Okay. You a tall girl.
I'm gonna just set them right here. But no, I have approached, and honestly, in my opinion, I don't feel like women are wrong as long as you're not really like throwing yourself on somebody. You know what I'm saying? If it's a coworker, or you know, like what they say, shoot the shot. But they got on the little breakfast club on the little segments they have. Shoot your shot.
That's right. Hilarious.
But yeah, so I mean, it'll be interesting to see if anything comes out of this. You know what I'm saying?
I mean, sometimes dudes be like, nah, you know, I ain't looking for that right now. Whatever.
Then she sent him a text and said, are you coming to Bible study tonight? You remember that?
Oh, yeah, but you know why he didn't go to Bible study?
Oh, yeah.
Because he met up with who?
Issa. And that was really cute. That was really cute, though.
They doing a little something.
That was really cute.
He invited her to an entrepreneur workshop.
Mm-hmm.
Told her what about that information, and he said that was his last little meeting he had of the day. Mm-hmm. Probably was waiting for her to come out of the workshop.
Loki.
So that was real convenient.
That was cute though, and I think that was nice to. And then I'm thinking about it. It was total opposite of how the show started. Like when the episode first started, she was all, you know, frazzled and checking the phone every 5 minutes. We ain't see sis check that phone that one time. But she was sitting there talking.
Right.
So it was nice to see that she ended on another note. You know what I'm saying? But
and the growth between them.
Yeah, man. Yeah.
They could sit down and talk. And they still had those little moments where they be looking into each other's eyes. Like, yeah. I wouldn't be surprised if either he go back to the house with her and Nathan show up there.
Ooh. Even these predictions, honey. Wouldn't there be something...
And we go back to the hospital, and Nathan's come knocking on the door. Bam, I'm sorry, I didn't, you know, all this stuff. This is what happened, blase, blase. Mm-hmm. It could be a number of things. Or, even Daniel. She go back to the house with Lawrence, and Daniel come knock on the door and say, hey, East, you know what?
These are possibilities.
I really miss you. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? I really miss having you around. I ain't been able to flow creatively since you left. You know, can you come around or something? Can I see you? Can I talk to you?
Yeah.
Something.
This last episode is going to be interesting, though.
And I hope it's 2 hours.
Yeah.
It need to be 2 hours because an hour is not enough time.
It's not
even an hour. 30 minutes.
Or 20. It's not a full 30 minutes, is it?
It's like 25.
Yeah.
We need 2 hours, Issa. We know you got it.
At least an hour.
And a half.
Mm-hmm.
Something. Yeah. That's with commercials. So an hour and a half. Something.
Yeah.
Because I got too many questions. We got to know where Nathan at, where Daniel at, what you and Lawrence finna do, what Molly finna do with Andrew. Is she going to confront Dro about this baby?
But really, why would she be confronting him, though?
Because he could have told her. I don't care if y'all not talking. We was friends before we even started screwing.
That's true.
You could have. The fact of the matter is, nobody really knew but Issa that we was screwing around. So if you knew that information was going to get
we
you.
Might feel like, well, if we was cool like that, then maybe I would have told you. But maybe, you know, as a, you know, some men no. like that, they be a little
you petty. Can't be that petty. We were best friends. All be, okay, besides all the screwing and all that other stuff, we were best friends, period. Yeah. So I don't want to hear no excuse. You could have told me. No, you could have told me.
That's true. Well, maybe he's not feeling that way. Maybe he...
Oh, that couldn't be his baby. Either way, you know, we, you know, they swing us or whatever the case may be. So maybe it's not his baby because remember I was telling you they didn't mm-hmm. show up together.
Mm-hmm. You did mention that last.
So.
I don't know. I mean, we spoke on Dro and Molly, I think, in our second video. Yeah, second review. And you said you didn't really dig them together anyway.
I don't.
I never really thought about them long term, to tell you the truth.
Me either.
I never thought about them long term.
I didn't think he was going to be in Insecure this long.
Really?
Mm-mm. I thought he was going to pop in, pop out.
Anywho, y'all. Let us know what your predictions are. Mm-hmm. Do you have any? I mean, I know you said... You gave a few.
I gave a few. I said maybe she and Lawrence go back to the house and Nathan pop up.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe she go back to the house and Daniel pops up.
Mm-hmm.
Or, I don't
really,
know.
That would be really interesting.
That's crazy. Maybe Dro and Molly hash it out and she'll figure out if that's his baby or not.
And she also need to figure out what...
Her and Andrew doing.
No, but what is it that you really want, sis?
Right.
And I think she owes that man an apology.
She does, because she was being...
She was way out of line. You know what I'm saying? And when you show... Well, I don't want to say when you show that part of you, because that is a part of her. But when you show somebody that in the beginning, and they like... Mm,
but he can't be too surprised about who she is. He's known her all of her life. They live next door to each other.
Right, who? Wait. No, I'm talking about Molly and Andrew.
Oh, okay.
You lost me for a minute.
What? No, she did apologize. She do need to apologize.
She do.
To him.
She do. She really do. Because it wasn't cool. Not at all.
No, she tried. She tried him big time. Yeah. And he really likes her. If he's willing to see how she was in Coachella all mollied up.
Okay. And still want to get to know her, like genuinely get to know her.
Kept a coat just to make sure, you know, she get it back and want to mean he got to see her again. Like, no, she shouldn't have did it, man, like that.
Mm-mm. Mm-mm.
But maybe she'll give him another chance. You know what? Ain't Kelly messing with the dark-skinned boy?
I know she mentioned him.
She said she was fucking him because she said she was like...
I know she mentioned
him. She was like,
him.
Is that the Chinese one or the dark-skinned one? Because I've been fucking the dark-skinned one a lot.
She said,
I've been fucking a dark skin.
She a mess, honey. She is a mess.
Why they didn't tap into Kelly to see if he knew what Nathan was?
Who?
Why they didn't tap into Kelly to see if they knew what Nathan was? Because Kelly is screwing the dark skin friend.
Well, see, I didn't hear her say that. I thought she said she would.
She said, no, I've been screwing him a lot.
Hopefully. My prediction is, for Issa's sake, that Nathan comes on back and he has a really, really good reason.
It either got to be death in the family or incarceration.
But he, and I just thought about this, he also been all over social media.
Well, he ain't been all over social media. He hasn't posted anything. Somebody had tagged him and said, thanks for the cut, bro. But that don't mean that cut was fresh. Even though it was
Did he say ago. Yesterday?
It said a day ago when he tagged him in that. But that don't mean that cut was fresh. You know, niggas be late on posts and stuff sometimes.
Well, that's my prediction. My prediction is he is going to come on back for this last episode. And he is going to tell Issa what's been up. And even if it's not a family emergency or anything, maybe if it was something where he would just, you know, confess and say, you know what? I got a little scared. Things are moving a little fast. I'm scared of my feelings.
I would rather somebody say, you know what? I can't take this pressure.
Yeah.
I like you,
but...
Or, you know, but this is a little too much for me. I didn't want to get this serious too fast because this has happened to me before. Honesty goes a long way.
Yeah, it does.
And
yeah,
you... It does. It gives us the choice to whether we want to mess with you.
Participate, yeah.
Or not.
And even if he was real with her like that, it might hurt her feelings, but at least I think she could respect. She may still have answers.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? But at least she could respect his absence.
Yeah, I'd be like, okay, I get it. It still would have hurt my feelings, but I'd be like, all right, cool.
Yeah.
And maybe I'm not going to mess with you no more, but I appreciate you letting me know the truth.
Just keeping it all the way funky. All the way 100.
Keep it 100.
Yeah. So, anywho, y'all, that is, I don't want to say today's, but I guess I can. That's today's review. We have one episode left. We have not really discussed or talked about what we're going to discuss next.
After that, she need to catch up on Love Is.
I do. We're gonna take this one to the boardroom and figure out
what's popping, what's good. And you know what? If y'all got any suggestions on what we should review or what y'all want us to talk about, go ahead and put it in the comments below, and we'll get back to it and just let y'all know what we decided.
Yes, and then also remember, I'm gonna put, if I had not done it already, because I gotta go back in and edit, I will put our YouTube channel's information in the description box. And I think that's about it.
That's it.
If you could tell, our energy kind of shifted a little bit. It did. It did. It did.
What you got going on?
Nothing. So, anywho, y'all, thank y'all for watching. Thank you for tuning in. This was The Review. How you love that? Yeah. I need a girl.